Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shall thou trust. His trust shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror of by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walk in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasted at noonday. But thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. Together, for he shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. O precious Father, once again, this is it.
Thank you for another Sunday that
was not promised. Thank you for all that is present here today, O Heavenly Father. Father, yes, you bless each and every church as church door is open today, Father, in your name. And Father, this is the special day that we ask you just to come in, Father, with your love and your blessings. Father, I ask you to touch the bishop this morning, Father. Father, I ask you to let him lead these your people in the way that you go. Father, the man that's going to break the bread of life this morning, Father, I ask you to touch his heart and mind, Father, that he will say all the things that you would have him to say. And Father, I ask you to go into the hospital this morning, Father, and bless those that are on the bed of affliction, Heavenly Father. Father, bless those that are behind prison walls this morning, Father. Father, bless those that are on the streets, Father, that don't have a place to stay. Father, I ask you to lift them up this morning, Lord Heavenly Father. Let them know that you are still God, and you will still lift them up, even though they're in a bad condition. And Father, we ask these prayers and all prayers. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Come on and bless God for our deacons. Amen. Amen. We'll be on a good start, isn't that right? We're already buckled up, ready to take off. And listen, I just want to kind of go down the program here real quick. Some of it, so I won't have to jump up every time. How many of you know it's good to praise God? Amen? And nothing like worshiping God. Amen. We praise him for what he's done, but we worship him for what? Who he is. Amen? Amen. Now let's just get with the praise team as they come. I got a feeling they're going to take us another level. Is that all right?
Amen.
I believe songs always loosen you up a little bit. Amen. Media following that, we're going to have amen, announcement of visitors. Then I believe at that time we'll come back here. Amen. Make sure everything's on track. Come on, let's bless God for the praise team as they come. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Let's give the Lord a hand clap on this morning. Amen. Amen. How many of y'all want to praise and thank the Lord on this morning? Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. How many of y'all come to have a good time with the Lord this morning? Amen. How many of y'all come to bless the Lord for the Lord on this morning? Hallelujah. Praise your hand and trouble. God is good. Not just some of the time, but he is good all
Thank you.
glory right now. Somebody said, I don't have to wait till the end of the year. I can give you glory right now. How many of you know he's your source? How many of you know because we're here today because of him? Amen. Somebody ought to give him glory right now. Can you tell him thank you? Come on, make some noise, Zion. Can you tell him thank you? Can you just tell him like you really mean it? Lord, I thank you. Hallelujah. 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 You know, whenever I watch my grandson play ball, I notice one thing. They don't really have to tell the people to make some noise. Amen. Something exciting happens, they just jump up and start screaming and shouting and they're rocking. Somebody know what I'm talking about over here. I wonder, is there anybody in here that know God has been good to you? And know that his son gave his life for you? Know that he rose? That's something to shout about. Amen. We bless God on today. Thank you. Thank you, choir. Amen. You are my source. Amen. I don't have to worry about that power getting cut off. Amen. All you got to do is praise and worship him, and he'll be there. Stay connected. Amen. Stay connected. At this time, we'll have acknowledgement of our visitors. And immediately following that, that's Sister Hightower. We'll have a tribute to our bishop. Amen. The daughters of Zion. And then we're going to have words of encouragement starting with Pastor Sanders. Amen. God bless these men of God. Y'all give these men of God a hand. Amen. Amen. Let me just acknowledge all the ministers that are here. Amen. Ladies, men, amen. We just acknowledge you on today. Amen. Then we'll continue with our tribute. Pastor Washington, amen. Amen. Then after that, we'll come back. Amen. Come on, bless God for Sister Kathy as she comes. Amen.
Father, which is in heaven, to Bishop Hightower, Assistant Pastor McKnight, to all the ministers on the roster, to you, my brothers and sisters in Christ. This time has been set aside to recognize our visitors. If there are any visitors in the house this morning, would you please stand and remain standing that you may be recognized?
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Well, we want to be happy families.
Come on, be happy.
We'd like to say to you on this morning, we're so happy that you chose. Oh, I'm sorry. Dee. Something would be said that would help you in your walk with Christ. And when you leave here today, you will have that peace which is surpasses all understanding, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. And on behalf of Bishop Hightower and the entire True Love Church family, you're truly welcome. Please come again. The thought for today is, when you find yourself sinking with life's storm, make sure you hold on to the anchor.
All right.
Make sure that I hold.
Amen. Are the daughters of Zion ready? If not, that's the time. We're going to keep it rolling. Somebody say, keep it rolling.
Keep it rolling.
Amen. Pastor Sanders, would you come at this time? After that, Pastor Washington. Pastor, amen. Are they ready? Come on, Pastor. Clap your hand for the men of God.
Some of the time he's good.
Come on, man.
But all.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
word encouragement is defined. The action of giving someone support, confidence, or hope. That defines Bishop Hightower. He is a man who's constantly giving other men, women, ministries support. And he gives you confidence to hold on when you want to give up. And he gives you hope when it seems hopeless. So to Bishop Hightower, be encouraged, man. To continue to stand. Just stand. And know God is God. God got your back. God got your back. These little God here in the presence of love you, man. We got your back. So in these last and trying days, I want to encourage you to hold on to God's unchanging hand. May God bless you. May God bless you. Amen.
Well, may God bless you today. Pastor Nolan Hightower.
Yes, sir.
The Bible does say in the book of Proverbs, there is a friend that sticketh closer than a brother. And I, time will not permit me to say how many blessings, how many blessings he's been unto me. But let me just say this. Graduated a few years ago. He was instrumental in helping me obtain a bachelor's degree and helping me get scholarships and things of that nature. So he's just a brother that loves more than just in word and in tongue. But he's a brother that loves indeed and in truth. A couple of scriptures, we're going to sit down. 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter, starting at verse 51, probably 58. Paul said, behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. And after this corruption shall I put on incorruption, and this mortal shall I put on immortality. Then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be unto God, through our Lord Jesus Christ, who giveth us the victory. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. May God bless Pastor Hightower and First Lady.
Bless you, Lord. Good to be in the house of the Lord. This is my bishop's birthday, and they told me to wear blue and white.
All right.
Amen. Now I don't usually serenade no men, but I got to say, Bishop, a happy birthday.
All right.
It's his birthday. Amen. Y'all ready? Y'all can check me. Y'all can help me out if you know the song. Thank you, Lord.
I'm gonna say, thank you.
extended this invitation to me. Yeah. I bring you greetings all the way.
Yeah.
Down the highway. I came up here.
Yeah.
But I live down here.
Yeah.
So say happy birthday. God bless you. And keep on.
Yeah.
Keep it up.
God for the daughters of Zion as they come. Amen. Come on, clap and encourage on this morning. Amen.
Oh,
Father Jesus. Come on and bless God, Father. Amen. The dancers, amen. Amen. They did a marvelous job, isn't that right? Amen. Nobody but Jesus, he kept me. Come on, somebody say, God kept me. Thank God he kept me. I didn't deserve it, but he kept me.
We ask, oh Lord, that you would just make us ready Make us ready to give an answer to someone who might ask us of the joy that's within us, Lord. The smile that we carry on our face, because we are a peculiar people, Lord. We smile in the face of trouble, Lord. We praise you when things are not going right. We lift up holy hands, Lord, even when we get bad news. Not only bless the angel of this house, but the entire first family, Lord. We all stand in need of prayer, Lord. So we ask that you would bless this blessed roster of ministers, Lord, the bishops and the pastors and the preachers and the doctors, Lord, but not only them, from the choir stand to the back door, Lord. We all stand in need of prayer, Lord. So we say thank you. If you forgot to tell them thank you this week, now is your opportunity. Thank you for being such a good God. Not because we've been good, but because you have been good to us, Lord. We want to say thank you. Father, for the furtherance of the service, Lord, we are in your hands. The safest place in the whole wide world is in the will of God. We are in your will, Lord. Lord, if there are any that are under the sound of my weak voice, Lord, that have not given their life to you, we will pray, Lord Jesus. They receive your word on today through a prayer, through a song, through the priest's word, Lord, that their lives might be changed. No one coming in contact with the master can go unchanged. Clothed in our right minds, being able to stand and to shout and to sing praises to God on high. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for every church door that's open in your name, Lord. We ask, oh Lord, that some change might take place today.
Have our instrument. All righty.
I'm just going to do a little something like this. She not in, that's fine. Come on, put your hands together. Come on, let's do it how they used to do it. Come on. All right. I have my mansion there.
Before we get started, do me a favor. We don't have church like we used to. I don't know how you feel, but sometimes in order to do things the right way, you have to get permission. Just maybe you need to ask somebody, can I have permission to shout? Just maybe you need to ask somebody, can I have permission to say amen? Or just maybe you need to say, Satan, get out of my way. Because I come to have church. Come on, can we give God a love offering?
Years,
pastor. Oh my God. Pastor will do something to you. And it happens to your birthday. Amen. Bad.
Yeah.
Can I go back?
Yeah.
Me not voting to say.
9:15 a.m. Sunday school is at 10:00 a.m. Sunday morning worship is at 11:00 a.m. Amen. And Wednesday night Bible study is at 7:00 p.m. Amen. If you are interested in being an adult or youth usher, please see Sister Sheila Cherry. Amen.
Amen.
Anchors Ashore, Bishop Eddie Hightower's birthday celebration is today. Let's give him a hand clap. Amen. Immediately in our event center after services. Amen?
Amen.
August is Men and Women's Month. Please see Sister Sheila Cherry for your calendar for a fundraiser. Amen. On this Saturday, we will be having our annual women's conference. It will be Saturday, August the 27th from 10 a.m. to 1 o'clock p.m. Amen. Here at Fresh True Love in our event center in the back. Please wear your hats for this day. There will be a prize for the best hat. Amen? Amen. Now, right now, I'm asking everyone, all the auxiliaries, if you have a presentation for our bishop, please get it together. We are getting ready to do presentations. Amen? That's one done. Two, we can also get ready for poem from Sister Williams. Amen? Also, I need to let y'all know that they want everyone to put on a mask when you are getting your food. Amen. When you get back to your table, you can take the mask off. But we have masks if you do not have one. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Okay, so now get ready to turn you into the hands of Sister Williams. Amen. But please get your presentations together and get ready to line up. Amen.
Amen.
Good afternoon. First, give praise to God and honor to you, my brothers and sisters in Christ. The poem today is dedicated to our bishop. Invictus. Out of the night that covers he, black as a pit from pole to pole, he thanks whatever God may be for his unconquerable soul. In the fell clutch of circumstance, he is not rich nor pride allowed. Under the bludgeon of chains, his head may be bloody, but it is unbound. Beyond this place of wrath and tears looms but the horror of the shade. And yet the menace of the years finds and shall find him unafraid.
All right.
Bishop, it matters not how straight the gate, how charged with punishment the scroll. For you are the master of your fate. And you are the captain of your soul.
With our presentations, we have a presentation on today. Would you please come expediently? Did I hear that word?
Yeah.
Amen. Expeditiously.
Yeah.
Y'all want me to try nothing? Amen. Come on, make your way in. Amen. Let's go ahead and be prepared. Amen.
To our present. This is coming from the women's nation. You know we love you. You know we're here for you. And it's just a little token of our appreciation from the mission to you. And this is from me to you.
to the minister of the hour, to all of our ministerial alliance, I am just a small part of First True Love, but I love my bishop. If he didn't know it, I'm telling you now, I love you. And I know, Sister Hightower, I remember years ago I said, if I was only, what, 20 years younger? Yeah. You would have some competition. Yes. I love you, Pastor Hightower. This is just a small token of saying happy birthday to you. I know these years have not been easy, but you hung in there. You said God will do it, and he's done it, and he's still doing it, and he's going to do it. Celebrate all this month. It's yours. Do it. Do it. We love you.
Praise be unto God and to the pulpit and the members that's waiting. I just want to say, this is my son-in-law.
Amen.
And I think he's the best son-in-law in the world. And I think everybody will think that. If you don't think that, then I don't know what's wrong. But I just wanted to acknowledge my son-in-law. This is for myself and my husband.
Bishop, my first cousin, Bishop, you are always a handful of them.
I do those calculations.
That's just a little bit far, but I, on behalf of the ministerial staff, I'd like to present to you our small token from our esteem to you. You are a wonderful leader. You are a kind person. You are a person that would give the shirt off your back. And you literally gave me a shirt off your back one year when it says Fisherman of Men. I don't know if you remember that. But you gave that to me. And not only did you give that, but you give your love, you give your opinion, you give your kindness, you give your help and assistance. I don't think there's anyone in this city and all these ministers up here and up on the roster that's a sign that says that you are the man that they will come after you
for the whatever. And I appreciate you, sir. Love you. Don't
take my mask. Bishop, this is from the usher
department. Amen. And we thank you so much for guiding us, showing us, keeping us in order, and telling us what to do. Now, I was instructed today to be your helper, to keep you seated. So I'm telling you again. Sit down and don't move.
It's from the youth group. And yeah, Pastor knows that we love him. He encourages us. And this is from Miss Nee. And this is from Tamika. We love you, Pastor.
Amen. Ain't no faking.
when he says that he loved the Lord. And I'm telling you, from a child on up, one day when it stormed right quick, me and Bishop was out making mud pies. And I asked him, "Brother, what do you think it will take to go to heaven?" It had been a horrific storm, had scared us to death. I was thinking about heaven. He drew in the dirt like Jesus, I'm thinking, and then he looked up at me and he said, "Believe." He said, "Only believe." That has stuck with me, Bishop, throughout the years. Such a profound from a young age. I love you. You are real. You are sincere. God bless you.
Amen. Thank you for your love, leadership, and guidance. Amen. Amen. This is from Deacon Lucius and Chandra Harris, and this is from the First True Love Choir. And this, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday
somewhere in the word says you reap what you sow.
And there's another story in the Bible where a woman was about to take her last cake meat, fix it, and her son and her going to lay down and die. But somewhere in the word, where the man of God said, bring me the first. And I can only imagine how she felt. All I got is enough for me and my baby. You want me bring you the first? But she obeyed the man of God. And she brought him the first. And from day one, from day on, it touched me back. She had more. So, Bishop, here's my prayer for me.
Amen.
And this is from Total Committed Baptist Church. We love you, man. God bless you.
Amen.
Say something, my brother. Amen. We're not going to prolong the time. We definitely don't want to leave without this man of God expressing his thoughts and his mind. I'll tell you why I woke up. He's bringing it. I'm taking the mic. I used to call Bishop. I don't know what he's doing on Facebook. I used to text him, happy birthday, Doc. I did it about 3 years in a row. He's like, well, that's just when I joined on Facebook. It's not really my birthday. Got it right this time, man. Amen. Can you stand to your feet and just bless God for this man of God? And then the last words for my speaker of the hour, and we will also bless our people. Amen.
Thank you. Truly, I want to say how much I really appreciate for all these men of God coming to see me. Thank you for, amen. This is at your own church. You took time to come and share with me. Listen, that speaks volume. And I want to thank each and every one of you from the bottom of my heart. I really got excited at our early morning service when I seen Brother Kevin. Brother Kevin came and we was in early morning service at 9, and I heard him speaking. I turned around and looked, and that made my scene, Brother Kevin. Then TJ came, and we TJ been with us on our Zoom Wednesday night service on Zoom, and this is the first day we got a chance to meet him personally, and I want to thank you for coming. I love a man always who is a man of his word. If he says something, then that's what I love. Again, first of all, but most again, I want to thank my wife. She has kept me and all through my sickness and all things going on with me. I said, Lord, what is it? It's one thing after another, but she stood there by me and concurred me and nourished me and loved on me, and I just want to thank her. My children, thank you for being there for me. My godchildren is here, thank you. Tyler and back in the back, thank you. Tanessa, we just love our, even my, the twins are here. Man, Lord, listen, Michelle, to me, listen, but I love you. Truly, God have done so much. Me and April was talking in the back, and I was telling when I get 65, I want to pass the baton over and be the pastor emeritus and let some of my young folks come and just take over. But then when you come out and see the love that true love has shown me, where my friends drive 100 and some miles to come see me, when my friends here, it gives you that push to want to push on and go on. But listen, I'm still thinking about retiring. I'm still thinking about it. But I'm telling you, God has truly blessed me all these years, blessed my family, kept us together when I was doing things I shouldn't, but he kept us together. And I want to thank God. See, when God can deliver you from something, you don't mind talking about it. That's those who haven't been delivered don't want to talk about it. So I thank God. God kept my family, kept me together, and now we can push a little higher. So again, Lightfoot, thank you. Sam, thank you. Golden, thank you. Washington, thank you. My son Daniel, thank you. True Love, thank you. I really, truly thank you for all that you have done over and over again. And y'all, let's give a hand out for them dancers. Didn't they do it today? Oh my God. I'm waiting to not throw it under the bus, but I'm waiting for my next deacon to get here. He's sitting over there by a keyboard. I ain't telling no name, but I'm waiting for that. When they tie the knot, he'll be my next first deacon. Amen. So I was waiting on him. I'm waiting on him. Amen. And where's Tamika at? Tamika, I'm waiting on him too. Amen. So I'm waiting on him. But listen, thank y'all. And my grandson,
he is
the joy of my household. Amen. When we want some happiness, I want some. Get us to just pray, Jason. Oh, you lose anything, he'll find it. So we just praise God. Amen. Thank y'all. True love. I love y'all from the bottom of my heart. Again, keep on keeping on. Amen. Love y'all. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you again for the dinner that has been prepared for all of us. Father, we just ask you to bless the hand prepared for us. Bless the service. Let it be nourished by our bodies. Thank you to everyone. And let it be great for everyone. In Jesus' name we say our grace. Amen.
Amen. Amen. As Bishop Lightfoot come, just one more piece of direction. Once he dismissed, Bishop already blessed the food. They want you to go around the sidewalk and go around the outside of the building. Amen. To enter the gym. Amen.
Thank you.
the Lord not say, what will it give me? Did the Lord not say, he would take us away?